It is okay to expect less from and believe that less is possible for these children because of their circumstances. But that's not what I signed up for. I didn't sign up to watch kids fail. I signed up for it. I said I would be. I promised myself to them as their dad. As their parent, my job is not to watch them fail, nor to expect less of them, nor to allow excuses about why they cannot. It's the opposite. It's to expect them to succeed, to expect from them incredible things, and to expect for them everything that they could want and dream of. It is my job specifically to believe that the most unlikely and difficult outcomes are possible for my children. It is my job to believe that and to act on it and to help them work for it. By the way, Tassie is not what we were told to expect. As many of you here who know her know, she's a pretty responsible, thoughtful kid. Though her development is in many ways delayed, she has somehow, against all odds, retained throughout her remarkably difficult life a positivity that is incredibly rare. Tassie is sunshine wherever she goes. Considering her background and the things she endured and witnessed, that is a miracle. That is God's grace. Sometimes, though, we're disappointed. There are plenty of people among us who know this to be true. And to admit this truth, we admit that we have made ourselves completely vulnerable. Because sometimes we're disappointed. Sometimes the people we love, have loved and fostered, do not live up to their potential. Worse, sometimes they hurt themselves deliberately, or even worse, hurt others. Sometimes those we also love. There are children of our congregation who have lost themselves. Lost themselves in addiction. Been overcome by their struggles with mental illness. Even those who have ended their own lives. And our responsibility to them still does not end. We are called to stretch our love. We are called to extend our vulnerability around even these awful circumstances. We are called to believe in our loved ones through each rehab, through each relapse, and even to the emergency room overdose. We are called to hope for them with each new medication and therapy, and to believe in the possibility of their recovery. We are even called to bury them with love, to pour out our hearts into their very graves. As I visit some of my children in secure facilities and communicate with their therapists about their progress. I know why I'm there. I remember what I pledged to. Even when I am frustrated by their persistent behavior, I love them. Even as they tiptoe up to accepting their responsibility for the things they have done to others, and then run away without really engaging, I believe in their potential. My belief in them is not dependent on their actions, nor is my love for them contingent on their behavior. Has anyone heard of Daniel Kish? Anybody? Really? No one? Daniel Kish is blind. He lost both of his eyes to cancer very early in his life. And he refused from a very early age to be defined by his blindness. He was believed in by his mother, his parent, and began doing something at a very early age called echolocation. It's what bats do. He clicks, and he listens to the echoes of his clicks in the surrounding environment. And by this, he can see. Not with his eyes, but he can perceive the surrounding environment well enough to ride a bike in traffic. This is true. And he really hates it when people find that remarkable. And he didn't want to make his entire life about being blind, because as I said, from an early age, he decided he didn't want to be defined by it. Nonetheless, he runs, at this point, a center that is devoted to teaching other children this same skill. So, he's answered the call. We'll try another one. How about Hugh Herr? Anyone here have heard of Hugh Herr? Striking out. Showing us. Hugh Herr, from Make Hers Yours, is potato chip brand from down in Lancaster, I'm going to seminary actually. Good potato chips. That's the family he comes from. He studied biomechanics at Harvard. Was a lifelong rock climber as well. Climbed, among other mountains, Mount Washington here in New Hampshire, and as happens, became disoriented, dug himself and his partner into an ice cave, snow cave, to keep as warm as he could, and awaited rescue. And they were rescued. The frostbite took his legs from just above the knee. Hugh Herr still climbs mountains. Hugh Herr took his experience and started a company, a new company, that designs and manufactures prosthetics. He was one of those responsible for the prosthetic legs that can let a person run as fast as a white-tailed deer, 45-50 miles an hour. He also built a set of cantilevered legs that shifted the center of gravity so that he can can stand on a ledge as thick as a quarter, and he says it feels like standing on a sidewalk. Remarkable people. People faced with adversity and people who found themselves in times and places in their lives where it was certain that they were not going to be able. But they were able. In the psalm reading, one of the lines says, "Give me space for salvation." All our love and hope and belief is no guarantee that those we love will be able to live to their fullest potential. But what I'm suggesting is that without all of our love and our hope and belief, they certainly cannot. We are called to give them a space for salvation. Not give them salvation. It's a little bit taller. But a space to find it. Another example. How about Bob Smith? An addict, a drunk, who created a methodology and formed a group to help him treat his own addiction and the rest of those who joined him in that group. Created a template from which Alcoholics Anonymous was born, dozens of other constituent groups to treat other addictions were also born out of the same effort, and millions have been helped by his attempt to find salvation. Even when life goes horribly wrong, grace exists. Even when we stray far from the path, even when we commit awful sins, we may return to God's grace. Our call is to believe this message. We must believe this message. You must believe it. Now I'm preaching like a Pentecostal. More than that, you must act. You must love the unlovable, just as you love the lovable. You must hold close to you those who have hurt you horribly. You must believe that we can be the hero in this story. That we can overpower hate with love, and adversity with hope. We are the children of God. We, each one of us alone, and all of us together, hold the promise perfect world. But we cannot get there if we do not love together, if we do not hope together, if we do not believe together. So now we will sing hymn 512.
Flooding in along the Gulf Coast, as well as
as those who are suffering in the fires, the wildfires out west. Prayers for Anna, who is suffering with Alzheimer's disease.
Prayers for my aunt's sister, Penny, who is having a finger amputated soon to prevent a dangerous viral infection from reaching her partner.
Prayers for Penny, who will be undergoing the amputation of her finger. Elaine. Prayers for the English grandchildren who lost their baby this past week. God, we come to you seeking acceptance. We come to you seeking healing. Come to you seeking hope. We come to you seeking love. We come to you praying as your Son taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come. Thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day. During the music, we'll be collecting the offering, too.
But again, you have a part in this lovely piece that we're going to play, and it's this little light of mine. You probably already learned this in nursery school. And this is your light. This little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm going to let it shine, let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine. You know that, right? The next one is harder. Won't let Satan it out. I'm gonna let it shine. Got that? Won't let Satan it out. I don't see your fingers. And then the next part is hide it under a bushel. No, I'm gonna let hide it under a bushel. No, I'm gonna let it shine. Hide it under a bushel. No, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. All right, you got that? You're our group, so get your money ready so that you can put that in fast so you'll be ready to sing.